Hello everyone. If you're keen to learn and wants to have hands-on experience in a real-time development environment, but you do not have enough budget to buy a MacBook, then you're in the right place. I am Mohsin Sharif, and I'm going to tell you how you can develop your first iOS application without a MacBook. As I mentioned in my earlier video, there are two parts of each application, front-end and back-end. In this video, I'll explain how you can develop your front-end if you do not have a MacBook. There are two ways to set up your Mac development environment. First, if you have any other computer running Windows or Linux operating system on it, then you can install macOS on it by using virtual machine. It's perfect for small tasks and testing purposes, as macOS may run a bit slowly on it, not suitable to be used for heavy tasks. But it works well for learning purposes. Secondly, the most convenient way is to rent a Mac resources online from any Mac service provider and pay them according to your usage by hour or month. But I'll suggest renting the resources online on an hourly basis. Based on the Mac services, it'll cost you a Mac $1 or 1 hour. For this, you just need a reliable internet connection and you are good to go and connect your development environment globally from wherever you want. To rent Mac resources, I'll suggest you to visit macincloud.com website and acquire the resources from there as per your need. They provide cloud-based Mac servers for app development, and they also have different plans you can choose based on your need. Their services and solutions cover a wide range of SDKs, for example, Xcode, Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code, Cocoa Ports, and many others, which is a huge advantage. You can also build or select your custom text specification based on your need, and they have weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly paying methods. Whenever you acquire online cloud-based Mac resources, please make sure their servers are hosted on Mac hardware. You can also visit bitrise.io to build, test, and deploy your native apps with continuous integration and continuous delivery and development built for Swift, Objective-C, and Xcode. And finally, Xcode Cloud Beta, which is currently not available for all, neither for all OS except macOS. Xcode Cloud is a new continuous integration and delivery services built into Xcode 13 and designed expressly for Apple developers. Those who got access to this beta Xcode Cloud will need a Mac running the latest beta version of Xcode 13 and an Apple ID with two-factor authentication enabled. I hope in future it will not require the Mac machine in order to access the Xcode Cloud to develop iOS application. That's all for today. I hope you liked this video. Stay tuned with us to see more hacks to develop iOS application without Mac. If you have any suggestion or question, please leave it in the comment section below. See you soon. Bye-bye.